Let's talk about growth hypothesis. How to formulate? If we do something, then we will get something. Usually, people are very lucky when they say if. If we simplify registration, if we, like, I don't know, make product faster, if we, I don't know, remove these fields, if we change the banner, if we do a better translation, blah, blah, blah. But then people usually like stuck. And usually if we do this, nothing will be changed. Let's do a new design. If we do new design, then nothing changes. So we do not renew design. So usually nearby then, the answer is nothing. If we make our product faster, then nothing changes. So it means no reason to do something. Good hypothesis could be if we change the title banner, then our registration conversion will increase twice. Also a big problem when we unable to measure. For example, if we test something that we're unable to measure, let's say with design, if we rebuild our website, then we will, and the problem is that to rebuild the website is sometimes it's very complicated things. And we were able to do A-B testing, show old website and new website. So, and we don't know what we will increase. We will increase only our opinion about our website. That's all. So the most important thing is if then, and then should be measurable. So if we a little bit talk a little bit deeply about that, so the action X will allow to increase the N metric by Y amount because of that. So the same example from my previous video. If we decrease twice registration fields, for example, we have now, let's say, 6 fields and we make it them 3. It will allow us to increase, let's say, registration rate C0 by, let's say, twice. Because people do not like to fill unnecessary fields. So growth hypothesis, they are usually testing by experiments. But of course, there are very variants how we can check the growth hypothesis. And of course, growth hypothesis means like we need some metrics to change. So it means product exists and we have existing customers and we need to increase some metrics, growth hack some metrics. And of course, many ways. Cast devs, of course. Of course, there are also many ways, but and experiments, we will talk about this later. Experiments is most interesting part of this, of growth hacking at all, I think. And what is important, if you do cast devs and you get answers from customers, and if you understand that if there are no energy here, you don't spend it for technical implementation. So if you have a growth hypothesis, you talk to your customers and you understand that they will not use it, so you don't need to spend time for experiments and for other ways how to check the hypothesis. So we'll talk about this very deeply in experiments part, so do not miss it. It will increase your business revenue, so don't skip this video about experiments. Okay, see you on next videos.